Here we're going to look at free convection in rectangular cavities. And what we're going to do is compare a horizontal flat section of a roof having the same dimensions as a vertical wall section. So for both of the sections, the surfaces exposed to the air gap are 25 degrees C, which is our inside air, and the outside air is minus 15 degrees C. And as I said, both of our sections have the same dimensions. So our H here across is 4 meters. And here we have our outside temperature, T2. Here we have our inside temperature, T1. And we'll do the same with this vertical section. We assume that the other sides are insulated, and the length of these sides is 0.2 meters. So we're going to compare the heat transfer rate for the horizontal section with that of the vertical section. And this is just our H horizontal A sub S times delta T divided by or compared to our H of the vertical section A sub S delta T. Since the A sub S and the delta T are exactly the same for the two, what we're really looking at is the comparison of our heat transfer coefficients. However, these are the same as the Nusselt number for the horizontal K divided by L, divided by the Nusselt number for the vertical section, K divided by L. And therefore, our heat rate comparison is just the Nusselt number of the horizontal section divided by the Nusselt number of the vertical section. So since this is free convection, our dimensionless parameter that governs it is the Rayleigh number. And since the characteristic length for these cavities, which is 0.2 meters, is the same, that means that the Rayleigh number is going to be the same for both of them. So our Rayleigh number is G, gravity, times beta, times delta T, L cubed, divided by the kinematic viscosity, times alpha, or our thermal diffusivity. So we need to look up some of these properties, and we look them up at a mean temperature of 283K, and our viscosity here is 13.84 times 10 to the minus 6 meters squared per second. Our alpha is 19.5 times 10 to the minus 6 meters squared per second. Our Prandtl is 0.713, and our beta is 3.5 times 10 to the minus 3 inverse K. So when we calculate our Rayleigh number, we get 4.11 times 10 to the 7th. So now we have to look up or find the proper correlations for each one of the sections. So the first one we'll start with is the horizontal correlation. So our horizontal Nusselt number is just 0.069, Rayleigh to the 1/3, Prandtl to the 0.074. And if we calculate that, that is 23.2. In order to figure out the proper correlation for the vertical Nusselt number, we have to take a ratio of that H divided by L, which is 20, and therefore the proper correlation for our Nusselt number for the vertical enclosure is 0.42, Rayleigh to the 1/4, Prandtl to the 0.012, and then this ratio H over L to the minus 0.3. So when we calculate our Nusselt for the vertical cavity, we end up with 13.6. And therefore, when we take the ratio of these two, which is the same as the ratio of the heat transfer rates, we come up with 1.7. What this means is there's more heat transfer from the horizontal section than there is from the vertical one.